Techno Viking! Wah! Oh, God. Oh, he just went head on with the freaking lumber truck. Yes!
Hello, everybody. Graystone Blaze, and we're back with more Piston Destruction Simulator to Time for BS. So there was a big old update to the game, and I am super happy about everything that was updated. First things first, let's get into our car here, and you will notice a distinct lack of Fezzy Dicycles right there. Yes, the dice are now default gone, which is really good. I don't know. Let's go ahead and open all of this up here. I don't know if anything's changed in here. There are two new types of ways to make money. And, well, I think one of them is a way to make money. Someone said that it doesn't make money, it does something else, I don't know. One of them is, there's the finish flag. One of them is doing, like, vandalism, which is, I think, like, throwing trash in front of the inspector place. And the other one is finding and delivering junk cars. So now, finally, those junk cars have a use. So we are going to be looking for finding and delivering junk cars today. I want to make a bunch of money doing that. Also, we're going to be doing that with the tanker over there because it is the best Toro we have. Oh, you know what? I'm going to do this real quick. Someone mentioned, and I don't know if they're aesthetically more correct than I am. I have no aesthetic abilities, so I will trust them. That the back shades on our window over here need to be the same color as the wheel, as the wheels. So let's go ahead and make this yellow and see how it looks. I love more yellow. I don't mind it at all. Oh yeah, it looks beautiful, baby. Get your candy ass up in there. Oh man, I was trying to get it on top of the bench. That was a friggin' swing and a miss. Our car is fixed, not because of anything that I did, but when I reloaded the game, the car got fixed. So we have a piston back, yay. Which is, did the car just like shuffle? Oh, there's like a little bit of collision now when I run into the car, oh whatever. So we're pretty thirsty, which means that I need to have a beer. This is the game telling me that I haven't had a beer in quite a while. Oh, by the way, people said that Topless Gun is back. You just have to click on it at the right time. Oh, I can't click on the... Here we go. Yes! Oh, Topless Gun. I felt terrible when I thought this was gone. But now that it's back and we can listen to the sweet porn music, my life is complete again. There's our buddy having a burger. Oh, while this is going on, let's go in here and get the sauna started. The reason why is because it is very late at night. We're going to have to utilize the sauna as we always do, because if we don't, we're going to end up getting dirty, and then the flies are going to drive me completely insane, and they should probably drive you insane as well. Go ahead and crank this way up. There we go. Remember to close your doors while the sauna is running. At the very least, it used to be a problem. I'm pretty sure it still is. Let's go ahead and turn on the lights too, because I imagine it's going to start getting pretty dark. Light over there, light over here. I think that there's one right over here. Okay, good. So lights are on. I went ahead and adjusted the wheel a little bit. I went and moved this one over to the right one time. So things should be moving pretty damn straight. So now I just have to find out if we have to wait for a phone call to get our job or not. Make sure that our phone is plugged in. It is. Now, if we don't get a phone call, maybe tonight when we're to sleep. Well, I'm going to have to unplug the phone while we're asleep, because if we don't, then we're going to get woken up by that jackass at the pub that always wants to be picked up. But hopefully we will get a phone call asking us to do some of the new jobs. If not, I'm probably just going to try and see if we can do them on our own. What is this over here? I just want to make sure that I have all of our food accounted for. I got an extra pizza in there, as well as a sausage, I do believe. A couple sausages in here, as well as a case of beer. Can't remember that a case of beer is there, because we need to... You know what? Hold on. Might as well get another one going. Oh, hold on. Let me get into the basket. And, huah! Damn it. I feel like I was gypped. The physics on the damn bottle has changed. I've driven around a little bit since the new update's around. I feel like the physics on the car has definitely changed. We can get a lot more air that I wasn't able to get before. Oh, yeah. We've got the Topless Gun music playing in the background. It's like Finnish opera, I guess. I'm not really sure what the singer is saying, but I'm sure it's something very poetic and intriguing. And so I've already discussed with you my plans. I'm also hoping that the shop owner calls us and tells us that the new parts that we ordered are in, because I would like to get those. Oh, while we're here, hold on. I haven't done this in the episode yet. There we go. Let me see if I can get some of the stream up there. Oh, come on, baby. We got it. There it is. Oh, yeah. Gotta get the old stream flying around. get this done. And the reason why is just because as we urinate, so to speak, it will increase our dirt level like one more time so that while we're here in this sauna, we can go ahead and get clean as we piss all over the hot stones. All right, so everything's good there. Let's go ahead and shut her down. Take this out, get rid of this. Shut her down, call it a day. I am going to grab something to eat, grab something to drink, go to sleep, and in the morning time, we're gonna see if we can complete some damn jobs. 6 a.m., another beautiful finished day. And is there a new light pattern here? Everything looks much brighter than it was before. Very interesting. Oh, before I forget, someone had asked what my settings were for the steering wheel. I'll go ahead and show you guys real quick. So this is what I did. I just clicked on the steering help, and then I have this for my numbers. I don't know what this means or how impressive it is or whether it'll help you or not, but that's what I do. So if that helps you, I don't know, pilot your vehicle a little bit better, then I'm glad. If not, then I'm sorry. So, with the sun coming up, oh, I want to show you guys something else. Here's where our dice are now. There you go. So if you want to move your fur dices, go ahead and do that. Also, the parts catalog. I wonder if there's any new parts. Well, it can't hurt to take a look, right? Let's take a look through here. All right, we got this over here. Very good. All that done. All those. Okay, so nothing new and exciting over here. I was curious. We got nothing at all. Can any of these... I'm just checking to see if, like, there's anything specific that's new to the game. Also, what does that say? Balfield? Is it like Garfield? But Balfield. Is that the name of Garfield in Finland, or is this just supposed to be like a little bit of a funny? I'm not really sure. You know what? Hold on. I wonder if we can. Can we dial it all? Can you do anything with this phone yet? No, you can't. Alright, that was worth a shot. So since we have not been able to get any phone calls yet, what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of manipulate some stuff around here. I'm going to clean up the driveway a little bit and hope that we get some new phone calls and see if we can get a new job. All right, man, what the hell? There still hasn't been any phone calls. What I think I'm going to do is drive the tanker to the store. The reason why is because people had mentioned that the last time I forgot to pay for gas. I wonder if I pissed this guy off and now he's not calling me anymore. I'm really not sure. I don't think that we're going to need the tools for this, so I'm going to leave them here. I mean, we're going to be driving the tanker, so it shouldn't be a big deal. I put a couple of pieces of food in the tanker, so we have something to eat in there when push comes to shove. While we're at it, I also have the wood chopping, the flat of wood is kind of hanging out. So if we actually have to, we can pick that up as well to generate a little bit of cash. You can see, again, 2,500 marks right now, basically nothing. Let's go ahead and start this thing up, head on out of here, and see if we can figure out exactly how this delivering cars bullshit works. All right, we are off. I've got the Finnish hammer of gratitude with us, just in case anyone tries to give us some shit. They're gonna get a beating, the likes of which they have never seen before. Now, what we're looking for is broken down sheds, which supposedly may contain a vehicle. And then if you find a vehicle, you can tow it. And you can tow it to, I believe it is the shop, and the shop guy will give you money for it. At least that's the idea anyway. All right, here we are at the wood area. If you guys have never seen how this is done, I guess I'll show you real quick so we can go ahead and make some money. Go ahead and throw the old back of this off. You just kind of left click on it. Now we have to go in here and grab our tractor, which I have lovingly left here for a while. Just because when I got all this done last time, it wasn't ready to drop this stuff off. He hadn't called me yet, and I wasn't even sure if you could drop this stuff off before he calls you, and it turns out that you cannot. Let's go ahead and turn on the ignition, get things going, throw the old parking brake down, and I'm gonna put it forward first so that we can back, because you need to back into this. We have to get this thing right about online. Whoop, there we go. Now we can stop, throw it in neutral, put the parking brake on. You have to throw the hand throttle on a bit. We need a little bit of auto throttle going. Now let's go ahead and move the rear hydraulics, which are right over here. It just takes a real quick flip. Now that's gonna go flying upward. Hold on, let me get out of this while this does this so I can show you. The wood will start spilling out right about, well, it should be spilling out by now if, you know, physics made sense, but this is like super sticky wood. It's like Finnish stick wood here. Very, very sticky wood. Very sticky wood. Son of a bitch. I'm not completely uncentered, aren't I? Okay, So I think the issue here is that you have to be totally on center for this to work. Now, don't make a mistake I've done before. You may be tempted to just start moving with this up like this. Don't do it. You will die immediately. Lord knows I've died that way myself. All right, this looks a little bit more legit. Let me try this. I think now we're right about on center where we should be. You need to be kind of like on this gray pad here. And things seem to work just fine if you hit it like right in the middle, right about here. There we go. Okay, well that's very interesting. Just kind of slid right over here to the left. Only in Finland. All right, buddy. Put that money in my hand. Put that money in my hand. Oh, yeah. $5,700 now. 5,700 marks, I should say. Let's just walk right through the wood. No big deal. Go ahead and turn this thing off. Close the door and get the frick out of here. Go back to the shop like we were going to in the first place. Well, there's nobody here. Son of a bitch. So that means that you probably cannot do these jobs on a Saturday. Okay, that's fine. What we'll do is, well, let's look around here real quick just to see if there's anything kinda new. Some of this looks new. Oh, wow, I can just phase right through everything still. So none of this has any kind of hitbox. Oh, except for this shitty car. Huh. You know, this car looks slightly more legit than it used to. Still nothing inside. I kind of wanted to finish headbutt to see if we could select anything. Doesn't look like we can, though. How about anything in the trunk? Maybe a little present or... Nope, nothing at all. You figure every once in a while there might be like some sort of Easter egg. Now, there is a vehicle in here that I can try and finish headbutt my way through. But look at that. There's just a big open area in the middle of it. That's something kind of new and exciting. And then over here, here's that other crappy car that kind of lays around. This has a hitbox as well. We can kind of punch our head through here. Looks a little techno-Viking-ish. And over in this region, we have the potential to do some sewage jobs. So I guess while we freaking headed all the way over here. So I might as well check to see if the sewage well is full. No. Okay, I want to show you guys something. So see how the sewage is pretty full, but not fully full? You got to wait until it's up here. If you suck this down right now, you'll waste all of your time and energy, and you won't even get paid for it. Well, I found something interesting. Our buddy is inside. The door is locked. It's still Saturday, obviously. And he is in a permanent loop, smoking over and over and over again. Remember, kids, don't smoke. At least not like this guy. Don't take a puff of your cigarette every 1 second, because eventually, he's probably going to die. I ended up arriving at the store over here. I managed to pay for the gas that I didn't pay for last time. Let's go ahead and pay for the post order. We might as well make a little bit of use of our time. Yeah, Oogle, whatever. Let me go ahead and grab our items. Now, this cab is pretty damn big, so I'm not too worried about being able to grab all this crap. And all I think we have is the spoiler, and then we have one other thing. What the hell was it that we bought? Oh, it's the steering wheel. That's right. So we got this stuff. I could probably fill us up with diesel too, just because we might as well while we're over here. Go ahead and chuck this inside, and that's sticking out a little bit, but what can you do? Let me go ahead and grab the steering wheel over here, and there we have it. And now that we have those, I'm gonna go ahead and put the D in the vehicle. Oh Jesus, where'd the box go? Holy God! Oh God, please don't do this to me, box. Yep, just kinda, no. Nope, just sit right in there, be good for me. Excellent. Go over here and grab the old diesel. Put it on in the gas tank, and then we'll head on home, get some sleep, turn this into Monday, and hopefully complete these jobs. Oh, Techno Viking! Wah! Oh, God. Oh, he just went head on with the freaking lumber truck. Yes! Just desserts. Oh, revenge is a dish best served cold. All right, it's Monday. Freshly showered or sauned, and we've got some food and drink in us, which is good. I'm going to start just going over here. Let's go ahead and grab the items inside of here since this is a new day. All of our crap exploded off, which is pretty much par for the course. Got a rear spoiler over here. I assume that this doesn't need any kind of bolts or anything as well. Let's go and try and shove it onto the car. Ugh, an ugly white color. We're gonna have to get that painted right away. How's it look here? Everything just kind of fits into place. The old finished headbutt to really check the mounting bolts on this thing. And now a brand new steering wheel. Want to get that in as well. Since we have everything picked up, now I'm just waiting to hear a call from, there it is, from the the shop guy, assuming he even calls us. If we get this on and he doesn't call us, we're going to go out one more time looking for frickin' broken down cars. And God damn it, I better find some, I swear to Jesus. 10mm bolt for this. Off with the old, on with the new. Let me go ahead and grab you and throw you inside of the garage. But why open up the garage door? Oh, the garage door just came open by itself. Whoa. And now it's closed again. Hold on, is it open or closed? I don't even know anymore. Hold on. Oh, shit. Well, it's not a day with Gray until he smashed something into the Satsuma. Oh, whatever. All right, let's put on the new wheel right here. There we go. Take out the old wrench and crank this thing down as best as possible, because I'm sure in no time it'll be out and no longer shoved in. Go over here, grab our paint can to paint everything up. This spoiler has got to get yellinized. Come on, baby, make it happen. Yes. Okay, wow, things are starting to look a lot better now that we actually have like a little bit of effects to our vehicle. Like I said, it's a little spoiler. Yeah, I guess even if it doesn't do anything mechanically, it's still nice to have on the car. Twist my mouse wheel. Still nothing for the gas cap area, so I guess we'll just have to survive without it for now. All right, so who wants to see a little trick for when your vehicle is stuck, this big-ass tanker? Get right behind the back wheel and watch this. Look at this. Look at this. You can make it fly like this. Oh, it's awesome. Oh, I love knowing this now, because now I can push this thing out of ditches without needing any kind of tow or anything like that. Oh, it's so magical. All you have to do is just grab the back of the tire and blam, this thing goes flying. Oh my God. Like a freaking oasis in the desert, I have finally found a vehicle. Wow. So there are not vehicles in all these barns, guys. Now, some of you have asked, how long does it take me to film an episode? Well, if you asked me today, about 4 hours, I don't even know. I've been driving around for about 2 hours trying to find a fucking barn with a car in it. Wah-wah! I'm gonna knock this bullshit off one time! I'd hate to, you know, it's like, who owns this barn? Because right now, we're vandalizing his barn, and we're going to take his car, and then I assume we're going to sell it for sweet, delicious finish marks. Now, in case you want to know where this barn was, there is the giant tower. You can find that at the northernmost part of the map, but you have to take this little shitty access road to get to it. So here's the car. Looks like I don't know. This is like a Firebird? Like a Pontiac Firebird? Well, whatever. So this is it, man. This is finally a car that we can tow. Jesus, hopefully. Let me go ahead and give it a shot. We're gonna pile on in the vehicle here. Let's go ahead and back things up, turn her around, and get shit lined up. Okay, I can just barely see it in my rearview mirror there. I'm gonna back all the way up to the door itself. No big deal. I wanna get as close as possible. There we go. A nice smash into the barn lets us know that we're right on target. Go and throw this thing back in park. And now, a little bit of a tow job here. How do we want to do this? I guess we'll get down low. Hit the old... Come on, baby. Where's my freaking towing hook? Give it to me, you rat bastard. Yes. Yes. Now we just have to find out where to tow this thing at. There has to be a tow around here somewhere. I'm going to get real low for this. Come on. Come... Oh. Right there. Okay. Boom. We got the tow going. Now to start this off, I imagine I got us in low range right now. And then we need to bring this to Fratelli, or whatever the hell his name is. We need to bring this to his place. So we're gonna need to pass this tower on the left. So we're gonna need to get turned around. Go ahead and do this, do a little bit of this, turn the parking brake off. All right, baby, here we go. Throw it into gear. Will we tow it? Will we tow it? Holy shit. Fuck me. Hold on, is it because... Oh, you know why? I just thought about this. It might be because we're at an angle. Hold on, let me go ahead and back up as far as I can again. And let me try and tow it out this way. It may be catching on the wall of the barn. In fact, I'll bet that's what it is. Yeah, that's gotta be what it is. Hold on, let me see if I can push this thing. All right, can you push a scrap car? Let's find out. Where's my pushing arms at, baby? Pushing arms out. Let's do this. All right, come on now. Get pushed. Get pushed, asshole. Okay, so you can't push it. Well, that's going to make things slightly more difficult. So I guess we're just going to have to do this at a hell of an angle and pray to Jesus that it comes out Or maybe Perkele or Satana will hear our prayers. Oh, you know what? Hold on. There might be a bunch of sewage in the back of this thing, too. If you want to see how much sewage you're carrying, little thing over here. Yeah, see, holy shit, that's a lot of sewage. All right, well, not only are we stealing your car, but there's a little bit of sewage right on your front lawn. No big deal. Hopefully, we still get a full price, even though the car's going to smell a little bit like human shit. All right, we got it pulled out. Oh, my God, it's flopping around. Okay, let's get turned around. So it will catch on the barn. So you gotta be real careful about where you, how, kinda how you do it. Go ahead and kinda get lined up here. Now remember, we're gonna need to pass this thing on the left. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll make sure that we're still carrying it. Throw it over here into the high range. Oh my God, my prayers have been answered. How long has it taken to finally find one of these sweet, delicious, juicy cars? And the reason I love this car so much, don't worry, I'm not just some sort of carophile or vehicophile, but it's because to me, this is worth delicious marks. And remember, we still need to get those marks up because we need to buy that freaking paint job, which is something I want to do. And plus, you get the opportunity to watch me expediently navigate these finished roads here. I do have my liftgate axle down, so we've got all of the tires touching the ground. I imagine that is a good thing, considering, you know, just the weight that we're kind of towing. And I've never towed a car yet, so I don't know. Hold on, let's shift down here. I don't know what kind of weight this technically is. It doesn't feel like very much. It just kind of feels like we're not really towing anything. I can't actually tell a difference. I wonder if it's still like soaring all over the place. It looks like it's pretty level now. No big deal. Okay, let's get to the shop and sell this bitch off for cash. Okay, it definitely has some weight to it. I can feel it when we're going uphill. We really start losing power. And in this big old beast, normally when you're going uphill and you have like a decent speed already, It doesn't have any issues trying to navigate it up slants like this. But watch, look at how quickly we're gonna lose power. So I have to downshift to keep anything up here. Oh my God, I have to downshift twice for this son of a bitch. All right, we're almost into town, guys. Gonna get paid up in here. Now I don't know where you're technically supposed to drop this off at. I would assume just in his driveway. Oh God, hold on. Let me throw this into way low gear here so we can get some more torque going. Let's drop this right about here. Should be good. Usually the gray area signifies where you're allowed to drop this. Oh, pussy. Whatever. Every once in a while, I just curse randomly. What can you do? Turn the ignition off. We're burning up tons of diesel. Oh my God, I can't even imagine how much diesel I've used trying to find this place. All right, buddy. All right, Futinari or whatever your name is. Fleetarin. Auto Carjarmo Malamo. Hell to the yes. I've got something for you, my brother. Yeah, put that money in my hand. Put that money in my hand. Futinari, put it in my hand. Put it in my fucking hand. Put it on the table, whatever. Oh, 4,500 marks, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, you son of a bitch. Hold on, I wonder if this shows us something. Let me go ahead and finish headbutt this real quick. I thought maybe this area, oh, you know what this is? This is the map for the rally. Crap. I was hoping it showed us where all of the barns are that might contain vehicles. Well, at the very least, we found one, guys. We got 4,500 marks. Holy shit, it took me the entire episode to do it. But we got it right here. Let's go ahead and detach our tow hook. Can I detach it over here? Yep, there we go. Detach our tow hook. That's one Pontiac Firebird dropped off. And now we know how to drop off cars, find them. But man, they're a real pain in the ass. I will say I didn't have to wait for a call to find that vehicle and drop it off. I just found it and dropped it off after I heard about the update. So that's awesome. But I think that to get the vandalism job, we're going to have to wait for a call from him. In fact, let me go over here and see if I can speak with him. No, I can't. I can touch him, but I can't talk to him. What's this envelope say? This just has a bunch of shit that we can't really mess with right now. How about if we go over here and try and talk to this bastard? Hey, buddy, how's it going? How you doing? If you click on him, he turns his head toward you kind of nonchalantly, but it doesn't really do anything else. All right, asshole, thanks for the money. I had to come down here and check to see if I could see a car. This particular garage was like right over here compared to the town. That's what I'm talking about, though. A lot of these don't seem to have any vehicles inside of them, but I had to at least take a look. Guys, hope you're enjoying my summer car so far. We found a new way to make money. Now we just have to figure out how to vandalize the shit out of whatever place we're supposed to vandalize. Until the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.